Hello everyone, I'm Brandon with Lenovo, and I'm here today with the ThinkStation P300 Tower Workstation. Today we are going to be replacing the optical drive. This process will take about 15 minutes, and it should be easy enough for anyone to do. There are no tools required to do this. Before we continue, we need to make sure that we are protected from electrostatic discharge, or ESD. Make sure to shut down the computer and disconnect all cables and accessories from the system. For further information, watch our Understanding Electrostatic Discharge video by clicking the link in the description. Now that we're ready, let's get started. In order to remove the cover, we must first remove two thumb screws. So now we just need to press inward on the release button, slide the cover towards the rear of the system, and remove it. Disconnect the power button cable from the system board. Next, we're going to remove the front bezel. You just want to press outward on the three clips to release them. Now we're just going to swing the front bezel open like a door, pull the cable through the hole in the front of the chassis, and remove the bezel. Before removing the optical drive, we must first disconnect the SATA and the power cable. Now we just need to press down on the blue release button and slide the drive out of the bay. So now we're going to remove the bracket from the optical drive and set it aside. So here we have our replacement optical drive. Now we're going to attach the bracket. Now we're going to align the drive with the bay and then slide it in till it locks into place. And now we're going to connect the power and the SATA cables. Next, we're going to place the bezel onto the system. First, we want to feed the cable through the hole in the chassis. I'm going to reach on through the other side and pull the cable the rest of the way through. Now we just need to align the hinges with the holes in the chassis. Once you have those lined up, you can just close the bezel like a door until it snaps into place. Now we're going to connect the power button cable to the system board. Now when replacing the cover, you want to assure that the tabs on the cover align with the slots in the chassis. So you just line those up and then press the cover forward until it locks. And finally, we need to replace two thumb screws.